Angelman syndrome, also known as AS, is a rare genetic disorder affecting one in every 12,000 to 20,000 births in the United States. The condition presents itself between the ages of 6 and 12 months and is characterized by developmental delays, intellectual disabilities, severe speech impairments, and difficulties with moving and balancing. In this video, we will learn more about Angelman syndrome by discussing causes, signs and symptoms, the diagnosis process, and treatment and management practices. Angelman syndrome is caused by a loss of function of a gene called UBE3A on chromosome 15. The cause of the loss in function is complex, but can be summarized as a chromosomal change or a gene mutation. A child inherits genes from both parents, but in the case of UBE3A, only the maternal copy is active. Angelman syndrome is typically caused when this maternal copy is damaged, missing, or inactive. In a few cases, AS is caused when two paternal copies of the gene are inherited instead of one from each parent. Children and youth with Angelman syndrome often have a happy and excitable personality, in addition to exhibiting the following signs and symptoms: developmental delays, particularly in the key milestones such as walking and talking, intellectual disabilities, short attention spans and hyperactivity, speech impediments, difficulty walking or balancing, stiff or jerky movements, frequent smiling, laughing, and hand flapping, trouble sleeping, seizures, usually beginning between the ages of 2 and 3 years old, small head size, and light hair, skin, and eye color. Diagnosing Angelman syndrome often begins with an examination of an individual's medical history, symptoms, physical characteristics, and laboratory test results, such as a blood test. A genetics doctor may also evaluate parental DNA patterns in order to accurately diagnose AS. Currently, there is ongoing research and development of therapeutics designed to increase the quality of life for those with AS. In fact, AS has been cured in a mouse model, which has led to several Phase 2 and Phase 3 research drugs currently being tested on humans. While there is no official cure for Angelman syndrome, widely accepted management practices are focused on specific medical and developmental symptoms. For example, medication to control seizures, and speech, occupational, physical, and behavior therapies. Individuals affected by Angelman syndrome see some symptoms such as overexcitability and sleep issues naturally improve with age. However, intellectual disabilities, speech impediments, and seizures tend to continue even as an individual matures. Regardless, life expectancy is not impacted, and with proper management practices, an individual with AS can live a high-quality and fulfilling life. This video is brought to you by PathCT and the New England Regional Genetics Network, NERGN. In addition, we'd like to credit the Genetic and Rare Diseases Information Center, the NIH National Library of Medicine, the Mayo Clinic, and the Angelman Syndrome Foundation for the information shared in this video. We would also like to thank Stephen Cofrancesco for composing original music for PathCT. If you'd like to stay in the loop, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media, where you'll get updates on future episodes and other programs. Thank you.